Hey, welcome back, everyone. It is now the end of August. Here we are, it is the 28th already, and we're not only getting closer to Star Wars Andor, but also getting very close to other shows out there like Tales of the Jedi, The Bad Batch 2, as well as Mando 3 and Ahsoka slated for 2023. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars updates. Also, by the way, guys, make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support. It is greatly appreciated. Now, one thing about the new Star Wars universe is that there's a lot of things happening at the same exact time between both John, George, and Dave in an attempt to really regulate the Star Wars franchise moving forward. Now, one thing that we do know about has a lot to do with the fact that a lot of changes are coming toward the lore and the canon, and a lot of which is going to have to do with the sequel trilogy films, and we're going to dive into this in just a second, but one thing that George Lucas and John have really been discussing for the past number of weeks now, in case you guys did not know, by the way, Favreau got a very big promotion by Disney over at Lucasfilm to really handle the creative end over all of the projects. We're talking about the books and the comics and the video games, the movies, the TV shows, etc. So Favreau is basically acting like a president of Lucasfilm without having that president title, officially speaking. So there's a lot at hand here. Now, when we look at everything related to both, of course, George, John, and Dave, is that they are currently crafting a new beginning for Star Wars, a new way to respect the Star Wars universe and the Star Wars fandom. So, this is where things begin to really get intense, is because this all involves the sequel trilogy movies and exactly what plan they really have to make some very detailed and drastic changes toward the sequel films, and let's get right into it right now, of course. So, with that being said, of course, with The Mandalorian Season 4 getting ready to go into development by both John and Dave, with a series of storyboards already complete to be finalized for the script, it's described that currently one of the big plans by George Lucas, Jon Favreau, and Dave Filoni are currently being put into place in order to create a fresh new take on the sequel trilogy lore and more as well. Now, one of the big changes coming from them has to do with changing the events of history that will have a big impact on the sequels. John, George, and Dave are getting ready to make it canon by 2023 that during the flashback scenes in The Last Jedi, that Luke Skywalker actually had a wife that was killed inside of the Burning Temple. This wife of his is said to be Mara Jade, that will become canon in the Mandoverse soon during her younger years, and eventually will make her way into the flashback events of the sequel trilogy movies. The main reason why they are making this change is to not only follow what happens in Star Wars Legends, where she also meets a similar fate, but that this is being used as a technique to justify Luke's actions of actually hiding away on Ahch-To and feeling entirely different about the way of the Jedi. Now, this main change toward the sequel trilogy is going to debut sometime during the holiday of 2023 that will change how fans view the sequel trilogy films and more. Not just that, but they will also be creating many changes toward the fate of Luke Skywalker and exactly how he was able to learn the force projection technique. The big retcon and or change that is coming for that is said to involve the fact that it was Anakin Skywalker's force ghost that taught Luke this ability in the Star Wars sequels. John and Dave have been meeting up with Disney on negotiating on editing both The Last Jedi and The Rise of Skywalker to add in some visual changes. So let me just pause here quick for a second. So not only are we getting a lot of lore changes toward the sequel trilogy, but also legitimate visual changes that are going to fit those lore changes. So what does this mean exactly? Well, if you guys go ahead and look at the special editions of the original trilogy, it's going to be kind of like that, except a little bit more involved. So basically, they are going to be adding in some visual cues, if you will, of exactly, you know, what's happening with Luke Skywalker using the force projection technique and how the force ghosts are helping him out, including Anakin Skywalker. This is something that John and Dave are taking from fans and making it happen and making it into a reality. Another thing is the whole Mara Jade situation. Now, they are going to add in some kind of visual cue at some point in time to the Last Jedi flashback scenes. What does this mean? Well, it could very well mean that, you know, we are going to be able to see perhaps an older version of Mara Jade, a quick little glimpse here and there, engulfed in flames or just flames around her inside of a burning temple and then cut back to Luke. Could be something as simple as that. So they're gonna be planning on adding in some small visual clips to kind of better support their canon changes that are about to be made pretty much official into the Star Wars lore. We already know that actress Karen Gillan, all right, who is, by the way, in the Marvel Universe, coming into Star Wars now. She has actually been hired by Jon Favreau to portray the character of Mara Jade in The Mandalorian Season 4 as a villain in the first, you know, few episodes, give or take. That's their plan. And then to eventually have her reform herself to become a more of an ally with Luke. And then eventually past Mando 4, they want to explore Luke Skywalker's romance and kind of build toward that change. That's part of the change that Jon and Dave want to explore, how Luke, in the beginning, is sticking with the ways of the old Jedi, where they don't get, you know, involved with love or emotion or affection or anything like that, and then progressing to where they kind of do fall into that. And I think that's a very interesting way of character development. It really is. You know, that's a perfect way to character development for Luke's journey to becoming the Jedi Master that he wants to be. So, this brings us to the next thing here, is that Jon and Dave have been meeting up with Disney executives, of course, on negotiating on editing both The Last Jedi and Rise of Skywalker to add in some visual changes. One of the big plans that they do actually have for visual changes is to add in, like I said before, the Force Ghosts on Exegol as well, that help Rey as well as Anakin and other Force Ghosts that help Luke achieve the Force projection technique. So, here we have it. Also, they want to add them on Exegol that are helping out Rey. Now, Lucas is said to have already given the okay on that plan, and Jon and Dave are excited to focus on editing those films in order to change and freshen them up. Now, with lore changes coming in the Star Wars canon, so will techniques of editing for the actual films to better fit those changes. Now, this, of course, is to be not to be mixed up with the 4-hour cut of The Rise of Skywalker, and that they are still planning to release that by 2024, but rather, these are edits to the films to cater to the lore changes that are being made for the fans, by the fans. Now, that's great and all, because Jon and Dave are basically people that love to achieve the fans' wishes and dreams come true. I don't know if you guys knew this, but Rosario Dawson as Ahsoka was a fan cast, and Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni listened to the fans and made it happen. The same exact thing is actually currently happening with the whole Sebastian Stan situation of becoming Luke Skywalker in live-action form for the anthology series called Jedi Knight. We talked about this as well. That's going to be announced officially speaking at next year's Star Wars Celebration. Keep your eyes open for that, and it's going to be a very interesting time once they announce it. But on the other hand here, this is a big deal. Editing the movies by throwing in, you know, small clips here and there to really enhance not just the experience and the story, but visually speaking, to kind of show us the lore changes that are coming into play instead of just throwing it in a book or a comic and hoping that people read that and how that's going to change their perspective. No, they want to really make this concrete to all fans, even the fans that only watch the movies. That's why they want to apply edits to the films. So overall, guys, you know, let me know what you guys have to say about all of this below in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time. Night to moon.